Welcome to Ibiza, famous for its sunny skies, beautiful beaches, and lush landscapes. But this Spanish island has so much more to offer, especially outside the peak summer season. This year, we're following slingers from destinations such as Spain, Finland, and as far away as America, all here to compete in the international championship to see who will be crowned the ultimate slinger. Coming up, Chika explores how the rise of an ancient sport is helping preserve the heritage of Ibiza. We'll follow his journey as he meets with our insiders, join slingers from around the world, see how they're inspiring the next generation, and even learn how to sling like a pro.
You make it look easy.
So get ready to see another side of Ibiza and discover what it takes to become the ultimate slinger. Ibiza is part of an archipelago in the Mediterranean called the Balearic Islands, a name believed by some to derive from an ancient weapon, the sling. Considered one of man's earliest weapons, it's most known from the story of David and Goliath in the Bible. But slinging began naturally and sporadically all over the world, so no one ethnic group can claim it as their own invention. And so well known were the people from these islands for slinging, they were hired as mercenaries by other nations to fight. So from the Greek word balo, which means to launch, we now call the four Spanish islands of Menorca, Mallorca, Ibiza, and Formentera the Balearic Islands. But what started as a form of combat in many nations around the world is today considered an indigenous tradition and an emerging international sport. It's a game of patience, technique, and power. And we're in Ibiza to find out more. With over 17 years of experience, Christian's won numerous awards for slinging and flown in from Austria to compete in this year's championship. He knows a thing or two about how a novice like Chika can learn to sling, starting with a few answers to questions like, what exactly is a sling?
This is actually slings like David and Goliath used in the famous story. This is a woven pouch. You can use a loom or either weaving over sticks. And the pouch is in here and the projectile would be in here. The famous pharaoh Tutankhamun had in his tomb four of these style slings. This is a braided sling, like they typically do in the Balearic Islands. And starting from one side, it's braided and then here it splits up. And by this way, you can shoot a very small lead projectile like Julius Caesar or Hannibal used or Alexander the Great, but also big rocks. At the end, you have a brake that breaks down after release. Otherwise, you would whip yourself.
Okay, so this bit stops you from
hurting yourself.
I see. Okay.
And the main principle is you put it on your loop of a finger for most of the slings.
Yeah.
And the other cord is held by fingers. Then you rotate slowly, and then with the force of the shoulders and the hips, you add power.
Yeah.
You release with the fingers, it flaps open, the projectile is released and flies tangentially towards the target.
Wow, that must take a lot of practice.
So the first few shots can go backwards as well, so yeah. Take care and you start using with tennis balls.
Yeah, be careful. What is this made out of?
This is clay. This is pure clay.
And these types of stones, they're not special stones. They're just around.
Yes.
Or they're not made specifically for this.
These are natural stones, okay. Mostly from beaches or from rivers. You can try it. It's quite smooth, as they say in the Bible about David's stone. It's like smooth stones.
Yeah, very, very smooth.
Because if they're broken stones, it would damage the sling on the one hand, and it will also have an influence on the release, so the precision would be less. Much more speed and more energy and
yeah.
Impact.
It's amazing. There's a lot more to it. It's quite technical.
Yes, and you see also in prehistory, people started to evolve without knowing the physics of it. They just this works better, so
yeah.
They probably did it this way.
Because slinging originated in different parts of the world at different times, how people sling can depend on where they're from. So the World Slinging Association has begun to unify the game by introducing rules.
For stones, they have two distances with 20 meters where he's standing at the moment, and for 30 meters. Hey, very good.
This is not a distance here though, is it?
This is also a distance. It's a 30 meter distance. It's a long distance for stones. It's
so like, people will from here manage to hit the target?
Yes.
Wow.
You don't try it out, perhaps, the slinging?
I would love to. I'm not going to be good, but let's give it a try.
For security reasons, put away the stone somewhere in the bag or on the ground.
Okay.
Are you right-handed?
Right-handed, yeah.
Then you put the right hand palm upside.
Yeah.
And then you put the loop on the middle finger right until the end and let it hold downwards to keep the fingers closely together. Otherwise, the sling gets lost throughout the shooting process.
Sure.
And the next part is to form a kind of a bowl with the hand, otherwise the sling would wind around the fingers.
Okay.
Go around the hand and lay it on your index finger.
Like this?
Yes, exactly. And then you press with the thumb on it. That's serious. Remember to form the bowl as well.
Okay.
Okay, now we can practice the release. The whole hand stays the same, only the thumb goes away. Just try it out. Perfectly, it
but
fell
keep,
down.
But I keep my hand.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
I would teach you the Greek underhand style, is it called?
The Greek underhand.
Yes. Okay. So for this sling, you need to turn to the right so that the sling hand is away from the target if you want to shoot in this direction.
Okay.
That's perfect. And then you rotate out of the wrist slowly in clockwise direction. Very slowly. There, that's good. And then when it's the very bottom, you release.
Okay, I release at the bottom.
Yes, this is good. This ball would have gone forward, so this is very good. I think it's about time you can start shooting your first projectile with a sling.
Let's do it.
So players can choose from two types of ammunition, hard projectiles or soft tennis balls.
I have no idea what's going to happen here, but let's give it a try.
The first few shots have the aim of getting the feeling for the release point. And always an important thing is also that the pouch is well balanced, but this one is perfect.
Okay. So everything is okay, like this?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, it's perfect.
Okay. I'm nervous. Don't laugh at me.
That's perfect. That's the official competition distance for tennis balls.
So like this?
Yes. Oh, well done, it went forward. You can try another one as well.
At least it went forward, yeah.
You know, 17 years ago, my first shot didn't go forward. Well done.
Thank you, thank you.
Well done, great. Your first shot went forward.
At least it didn't go back.
Scoring is mainly done acoustically. Hitting the wooden square earns 1 point, while striking the metal circle, known as the Diana, earns 2 points with a resounding gong to announce the bullseye.
Wow. Must be an amazing feeling when you hit the target.
Ah, yes, it is. And you get this bell sound, and you're like, first the whip crack of the sling. It doesn't break. It actually explodes like BAM!
Wow.
This huge sound, it's really...
Must be an amazing feeling.
Yeah, and most of the time the crowd cheers as well then.
Yeah.
Yay! You did very well.
Thank you very much, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in the competition. I'll be cheering you on.
Yeah, thank you. That's very nice of you. So perhaps one day you will want to compete as well. So
maybe.
We will be love to have you there.
And this is where all plans go out the window. Competing did not cross our minds and is definitely not on the agenda.
These five competitions, the upcoming ones, three of them are with tennis balls. You should compete there from the 13 meters. All your balls went forward, do a little bit of practice, and you might score the one or other point. This would be great. So
I think I would. Maybe I need a bit more practice, though. But
doing is the best way of learning it. You have a good style of movement. You seem to do other sports, and this is always beneficial for slinging. So yeah, it would be great if you have to have you there. I would cheer on you as well.
Yeah, I'll give it a try. Yeah, I just hope I don't embarrass myself. I hope at least I can get the ball forward and don't go back.
Might even be the UK representative, so no pressure on you.
Yeah, I can represent the UK. I just hope I don't embarrass the UK.
Well, I don't know how he got himself here, but here we are. Chika, the untrained slinger, may actually compete. So since it could actually happen, he needs as many tips as possible. And he's at the right place at the right time because these guys are some of the best slingers.
Hey everybody, me again, Taylor, right from Fireport.
From the deep south of the USA and with over 500,000 views online, Channing's making a name for himself on both sides of the pond. And best of all, he has a unique approach to slinging that maybe Chika can learn from.
I played baseball when I was a kid and everything. And when I seen it, because I never even knew about it, I heard about it, David Goliath. But when I seen it and seen the power, it just was like, okay, let me try it out.
Yeah.
I went and tried it out, and then with my baseball skills, it came easy. I always did like primitive weapons and stuff, you know. I'm good with blow guns, bow and arrows, and all that good stuff, you know.
You picked it up very quickly.
Yeah, yeah. And I like my guns, but ammo's a little expensive right now, so this
so
is
you
cheap.
Stick with these, yeah?
That's it, that's it.
Essentially the ammo.
This is the ammo,
right?
Yes.
And is there a, like I saw you picking stones, is there a particular shape or is there a particular, like how do you decide?
Okay. See, for me this is different. This year or over here, I'm using these big ones.
Yeah.
Because for some reason, they're going where I need them to go. You know what I mean? And but like the perfect size, like right here.
Okay.
189 grams.
Right.
That's about a good weight. It's a little heavier on the weight than you use.
Okay.
But the
it's actually written on. It's written on the stone.
Yeah.
So this is the weight of the stone.
That's the weight. Yep.
Okay.
So that's 189. I think they had a big one right here somewhere.
And does it make a difference? The size. Does it really make a difference?
It makes a big difference. It makes a big difference. And when you pick your rocks, you want to get a kind of the same size.
Yeah.
Cause say you're throwing and you're high right. So you're like, all right, I'll bring it down a little bit. But if you throw too light of a rock, you know, it might go too far or it's hard to adjust
if the
ammo ain't the same.
Okay, so you're essentially looking for a particular size and trying to keep it a consistent size.
Yeah, and like you would think you wanted like a baseball, but actually you kind of want like a football looking. Yeah, because you want it to grip it like that. Most slings don't have this in the middle, but when I started slinging, my rocks will fly through. So I put this on it, and now they don't fly through. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I think that's why split pouches are the best.
Yeah.
Cause think about a baseball, right? That's a fastball, you know? And you want to throw a change up like that. You know, so if you got a sling that's fully in there, I feel like it's not as fast.
Are there competitions in America as well?
No. Not yet. I'm gonna work on that.
You're working on that. You're one of the pioneers.
Yeah, this is too cool not to make it happen. You know what I mean?
Yeah, of course.
It's a good way to get in touch with everybody, and just see different ethnicities and all that, different people.
And this is your first time in Ibiza?
Oh yeah, it's my first time out of the States.
Your first time out of the States?
Out of the States, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm a little country boy from Louisiana. I never been out the South. I don't throw like a typical balearic sling. I kind of throw like a pitcher, so I got a big curve on it every time.
Right. And I guess that comes from the baseball, the style that you use. Is that coming from your baseball days?
Yes, sir. I don't see why we're not in the Olympic. You know what I'm saying? They got speed walking, they got darts. The most ancient thing, you know what I'm saying?
Well, absolutely. Maybe one day we'll see you in the Olympics, representing the USA.
Oh, what? Hell yeah. I would love that. Follow your dreams.
Follow your dreams, yeah. Must be a nice feeling when you hit that.
That's it. Oh, it was the best. Euphoria.
Had a little bit of practice, so it's like this.
Yeah.
Hold the knot.
Yeah.
Okay, like this.
Enter Carlos, a physiotherapist and slinger from Madrid, who now lives in Ibiza. He's mastered the sling and together with Club J.A.S.A. organizes slinging events.
And then you have to roll on to feel, just to feel the weight of the ball. And then when you feel the moment, and you have to throw it. Step one like that. Yeah, and try not to move your foot.
Keep my feet still.
Yeah. Very, very nice. Very, very nice.
I can see how this could be quite addictive.
Yeah. Yeah, something like that. Wow. Like that. Proud, no?
I was straight. It was straight.
Yeah, straight, no.
I think I was moving my feet too much.
Yeah.
How am I doing? Am I doing okay?
Yeah, very good. Nice. Very, very good. Please go on your right. It's because you release too earlier. And when it's passed, it's too late. 1, 2, 3. That's in the center.
Carlos has been slinging for 4 years and it shows.
You make it look so easy. You make it look easy. Drats. You know, you really want to hit the target. You just want to practice and practice and practice. You can see how so much time can go past. Release it a bit earlier.
Yeah.
A little bit earlier.
That's it.
Okay. Still, last try.
Yeah! That's it.
Thank you very much.
Very nice. Very
finally!
Good. Yeah.
I hit the target. I got it once. I hit the target.
So Chika scored 1 point by hitting the board, but still waiting to strike that Diana. After freshening up back at the hotel, I think all our heads are spinning with the news Chika can officially compete. He's no longer just an observer, but now considered a fellow slinger.
So we're just on our way to Ibiza town for the opening ceremony of the event. There's going to be officials there, there's going to be some traditional dancing, I believe. So it'll be really nice to see Ibiza from a cultural perspective. As you can see, there's other people on the coach, they're the other competitors in this event. I think we're going to another hotel to pick up some other competitors, so it'll be really nice to see them too. And yeah, really looking forward to this evening.
The whole event is an open celebration of culture, even down to the traditional clothing. Tonight, we're heading to the government of Ibiza for the initial gathering and our first glimpse of Ibithinkan heritage. The first competition was formed in 2011 by a group including the late Mateu Roca. But since passing, his friend Pep and Club Hassa have transformed the event into a World Cup championship. Once a politician, Pep now organises some of Ibiza's largest events, including the island's longest-running quadathlon. Ooh, looks like it's about to start. This typical Ibithinkan dance is called bolpakes. Moving to the drum and flute of the soñador, the women step speedily but steadily, creating a floating illusion, meekly drifting in circles while keeping the gaze of their eyes away from their male partner. Clapping their wooden castanets, the males energetically hop and raise their legs, seeking their partner's attention. Never should they turn their back to their lady, and never should their eyes meet.
Just taking photos with the amazing performers.
The Institute of Sports wants the world to see Ibiza is more than a party destination. And sports will play a big part in this. They were even awarded the opportunity to host the Multi-Sport World Championship in 2023. Chika's finding out more from our two insiders. Head of Sports Salvador J.A.S.A and Tony Ramon, the Head of Sports in the region of Santa Eulalia.
Ibiza is well known in all the world since the 60s. A very popular place to be, and for our sand beaches, our sea, and also for our nightclubs. No? Yes. But Ibiza is more than that.
We are working for more touristic options. You know, 10 years ago, the main thing that you can see if you are from out of Ibiza is the night, yeah, and the disco, and the sun, and the beach. So we have international athletics races, we have international mountain bike and cycling races, we are organizing events, cultural events. So the goal is to have more opportunities for half people in Ibiza.
You can see and discover that Ibiza has culture, has gastronomy, very nice countryside. And this is why we promote and we support
a lot of events. So
the plan is to make it more of a year-round destination for people.
Yes.
I was practicing the slinging, Balearic slinging, earlier today. Channing, he's from the USA. He's visiting Ibiza for the first time. He was saying that he's looking forward to the day when Balearic slinging is in the Olympics.
Let's see, it's possible.
Yeah,
let's see. The slinging here in our community in Baleares, it's a cultural sport. Institutions have to protect them and invest that to grow that sport. The industry of the sports, they are focusing and looking at Ibiza to find a site that has all the ingredients, all the things that can allow big events and attractive for the people to come, and we have the space and the countryside to make this event possible. Discover Ibiza.
Yes, pleasure. Thank you.
Their plan is to make Ibiza more diverse and attractive to tourists all year round. And the Slinging Championship has its own part to play. This is the beginning of what could one day become a global televised event. We're one day closer to the championship, and tomorrow's a big training day around the island.
I was running a bit late and almost got on the wrong bus, but fortunately he made it just in time.
It seems the championship acts as a reunion for this global community, and a way to meet others who share the same hobby.
Oh, that was sweet.
Slingers like Joseph, who's originally from the UK, but now lives in and represents Finland in the championship. He hosts a podcast dedicated to sharing tips and insights about the sport, like how to make a sling crack just like a cowboy.
Well, it works in the same way that a whip does. The sound is basically made by the uncurling of the sling. So when you have the sling on your finger and the stone loaded, when you let go, the sling is unfolding. And because it starts off thicker down here and then tapers down, when it gets to the very end, it's multiplying the force. So the end of the sling is going very fast and it goes supersonic and breaks the sound barrier, which is the crack.
Wow. So it's like a sonic boom.
Yeah, basically.
Oh, wow.
And then you can add a cracker on the end in the same way that a whip has, which then multiplies the force again and makes that much louder sound.
So does this make a louder sound?
Yes, this really cracks loud.
Okay.
One of the reasons that they sort of made them so that they would crack is if you're herding animals or trying to scare animals away from the herd that you're looking after, having that loud crack sound will scare off the animals direct the animals in certain ways. So you could use it even without a stone in it, just for scaring off an animal just from the sound.
Right.
With today being Friday, many more competitors will arrive tomorrow. But for those already here, today's about getting as much practice as possible.
There's no competition, there's no points, there's no prizes, only exhibition for the children, right? The distance, it doesn't matter, it's more or less this distance, 13 meters for men and 10 for women.
To start us off, Mr. Lopez takes the opening shot.
Bien.
And with that, it's time to sling. When together, it's easy to compare the different ways people sling, from how they turn and gain power to the timing of their release. Meanwhile, Chika's beginning to get the hang of it.
Hold it from here.
No, down here.
That wasn't bad. A bit more practice and I'll get it.
Oh yeah, sure. It's definitely the pressure from the crowd.
Not bad. Determined to hit the target at some point during this competition. If you try and force it, use too much force, that's when it's going wrong. I need to just calm down and just focus on getting the technique right rather than the power. Hey, like that.
Oh, That bull got caught in the fence.
It worked.
Okay, we're gonna have to start cutting some of this out. Okay, now they're watching you.
Getting used to a different technique now. I normally have it here, but he told me to put it on this finger instead. It's a bit like golf. Mental, it's almost mental as well as it is physical. You know, you have to think about so many different things, think about your body position, think about the power, also concentrate on the target, because sometimes I find when I'm going through the motions, but I'm not actually concentrating on the actual target. And I find if I focus on the target, I get a little bit closer. Was that last one, I wasn't even looking at the target and it just, you know, went miles away.
But it's your first time you use
it? First from yesterday, so. Oh, thank you. She says I'm good for my first time, so that's good, that makes me feel good. You were like the superstar, the kids loved you.
Yeah, they did.
It must be the flag, I think.
The flag and the hat.
So we've just finished the practice session with the kids in the school. The kids were loving it. I was getting lots of support. They were cheering my name. It's been a really good morning. Worked up a sweat. Really, really having a good day.
From the first training session, we noticed something peculiar about one of the slingers. And perhaps you have too. From shooting like a baseball to the Greek underhand, we've already seen a few unique ways people sling. Some rely on getting a spin above the head. Others rely on releasing at the right moment. But one contestant relies on feeling the ground beneath his feet, an approach no one else seems to be taking.
2 million years of evolution.
The foot is the best.
Foot is the best.
Wow.
-5.
-5.
It's okay. Under -5, it's crazy.
but even -5 is okay?
Yeah.
You have to drink a lot of vodka.
Yeah.
We should be back on the road by now, but everyone seems very interested in the gentleman and the slings around his neck.
Who is this guy?
Diego Camunas, he makes slings and he made this one.
Oh wow. What's the material? Like, where does it actually come from?
I think most of these are the agave fiber.
Okay.
Which he used to collect the plants and process, but you can also get it from just rope that they use for baling up hay.
Do you know how long it takes, roughly, to make one?
It can depend on what sort of style they're making and stuff like that, but it can take a good few hours. I've made some slings before using natural fibers that I've collected myself, stinging nettle, actually, you can use to make cords.
Oh, really?
And I've used the fibers to make a sling. It feels very rewarding to actually make a sling yourself.
Oh, yeah,
and
I can imagine
it.
From start to finish.
It really is. But yeah, if you want a good sling, he's a good guy to go to, yeah.
Okay. So how much do they cost?
I believe I bought this one for 15 euros or something, so not much at all.
Okay. It's not an expensive sport.
No, that's the great thing. I mean, with the one that I made out of nettles, it cost me nothing except my time, maybe. The great thing about slinging I found is that you can go as complicated or as simple as you want. You can spend literally days working on like a really complicated Peruvian style braid where you're braiding. Or you can take 2 shoelaces and a bit of leather and you've got a sling. This was not as cheap as the ones made from grass and stuff, but this is goat hair and then wool as well. It has this very large, thing.
So is this a bit that you hold? Oh, okay, this goes through there.
There is a hole through there. A little different to something like this, which
of course.
You know, just course. Very simple, so. There's a whole craftsman side of it. You don't even have to be good at slinging if you like just making it.
Yeah, exactly.
There are people that have like the one sling that they have and that's the one they use forever.
Yeah.
And then other people, I kind of think of it as more as part of it is kind of collecting.
Yeah.
Like I'm really interested to see how people make slings, what sort of styles they use.
Man, it's like a whole new world I've just been introduced to.
We're back on the road, heading to our second school in the beautiful town of Santa Gertrudes de Frutera, named after the fruit trees that grow here. It's a warm day, we have the Diana, our slings, and still, no shoes. Wow.
It's really pretty, very picturesque, very peaceful, lots of people sitting around having coffees, looks like it's a popular cyclist point for people to stop.
We will meet a lot of children, I think.
And do some more practice, yeah?
Some more practice, yeah. And we need a toilet and something to drink and a coffee.
Exactly.
The championship is open to women all over the world. Women just like Miriam, an archaeologist from Austria and one of the few competing.
Yes, we are a women's team. Look, we are the Slinger Amazonen.
Ah, yeah, I see. So. Okay, what does that mean?
Amazonas.
Amazonian
northern ladies.
Yeah, I see.
And Slinger is slinging. I've worked a lot in museums.
Oh, really?
And we have Celtic festivals.
Okay.
Very strange one where everybody tennis. Costumes.
Yeah, like people dress up.
Yeah. Oh, okay. All villages dressed up like Celts.
Okay.
And there are different activities.
Okay.
And music, Celtic music.
Wow. And how long have you been slinging for?
Well, actually now 2 years.
2 years.
Yes.
2 years. Okay, yeah, you must be good.
Well, no. Well, we will see.
We will see. 2 years, 2 days.
Okay. Yes.
Not but even 2 days.
I saw you slinging. You're perfect.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much.
I think you will be a very good slinger.
Do many women do slinging? Is it popular amongst women, or is it mainly a male?
Last year, so when we founded our group, some said, make a women team, because there are women teams in Mallorca would be fun. We thought, okay, we go to Mallorca, and. Yeah. For sure, we do not win anything.
But you have fun.
Yeah, and we had so much fun, and it was so easygoing that we won the competition.
You did?
Yes.
You won?
Yes. Oh, wow. We came home as the mouse. It was
wow.
So funny.
Unexpected.
It was totally unexpected.
Oh, well done.
But it was just because we were so easygoing and okay, it doesn't matter. Yeah.
And you won the whole thing.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. The men must have been a bit upset about it.
Well, it was the women's winning. I thought the men had.
I see.
Especially when we came home, it was so fun. Whole village was there with the mayor, with flowers, with something to drink.
Yeah,
with a big transparent welcome home. It was
so nice.
It was really nice.
Like celebrities.
Yeah.
Oh, excellent.
It was really nice.
Well, ladies, that's your cue to sign up. But we've made it to the next school, ready to inspire the next generation.
Antonio Reines, the Campanet. Chika from Inglaterra. La Bucci del Tibet. Paco, de Cantabria. Las banderas Amazonas. Cristian, d'Austria.
Okay, so Chika has some notes for the editor. Cut that. And that. Keep that.
Got it. I'd like to say I'm getting the hang of this, but it's just sheer luck. Oh, there you are. Superstars.
Yeah. You're a superstar till tomorrow.
All this slinging builds an appetite. Thankfully, Pep and his team have put on a spread.
Oh, wow, look at this. After a long morning of slinging, what better thing to do than to have some amazing Spanish food?
Sausages, tortilla, pastries, fish bites, and a cool drink to wash it all down with. A much needed taste of local cuisine.
Very nice.
After refueling, the slingers are given one more practice round at one of the island's most beautiful venues. Ibiza Botanical Biotechnological, a botanical garden where nature fuses with technology, like this one-of-a-kind plant piano that plays from the touch of a hand. But back outside, these are the final moments before the big day arrives.
Good.
Thank you. I hit the board, I can't believe it.
We're one day away from the big game, and although Chica's getting a few shots, I reckon, deep down, it's all getting very real for him, especially after what Christian said.
Might even be the UK representative.
Representing the UK are big shoes to fill, and who can forget the disappointment when he missed?
2 million years of evolution.
He's going up against 2 million years of evolution with less than 2 days training. He needs something outside of his comfort zone, and I can see it now. Dark clouds loom over the island. Chika calls upon the ancient power of the sling to grant him the strength of a mountain and accuracy of an eagle. Lightning strikes. The heavens bear witness to the immense ability, awe, and wonder that now resides in the reborn Chikunda. For some reason, he'd be running, doing pull-ups, and whatever it takes to make this sequence look intense. He peers out to the sea, preparing to slay any slinger who dare takes him on. He strikes. Earth is no more. Or we could not take it so seriously and just have fun. That's an option.
So it's a beautiful morning here in Ibiza. We're on the east side of the island. The actual competition starts today. Yesterday was more practice. We've got some more competitors, some more people over from Mallorca, some people from Catalonia as well. Yesterday we were using tennis balls, but today is the first time we're going to be using the actual stones, which I've never actually done before, but I'm looking forward to it and I'm sure it'll be a lovely day.
Celebrity Channing is helping fans of his YouTube channel understand his video intros with that American accent.
Yo. It's me again, Channing, Practical Fire.
Okay.
Hey, everybody.
Seems like there's quite a crowd. Even the Ibizan hounds are making an appearance, an intelligent, athletic, and Spanish breed that originate from this island. But the greatest thing about the championship is everyone's supportive and they help each other do their best.
This sort of size?
Maybe this one's not so rounded, so.
That one?
Yeah, that's a good sort of size, yeah.
Okay. And how many goes do you have? Five?
You have five, so two more, about the same size.
All right, good to go.
I think if you manage to get it to go forward,
that's, I know, I've never ever done it before with stones.
That'll be an achievement in itself, so.
But of course, everyone's keeping one eye on those trophies.
Wow. Wait, hello. Hola. So it's first go on the stones. It's a lot, it's actually a lot bigger than I was expecting. I wasn't expecting quite so many people here with the trophies, and it's quite a serious event.
But still, it's all in good fun. Like, people will be cheering everyone on. It doesn't get too competitive. It's
fine. A little bit nervous.
It's fine, yeah.
I don't know if the camera does it justice, but it's a lot further than it actually appears. Wish me luck.
Attention, please. Atención, por favor. Hombres, Diana A, Gustav, Chica, Yaseslav, Uwe, Adrian.
Why am I second?
John, Diego, David.
Why?
So each slinger has two rounds of five shots. Remember, hitting the board is worth 1 point, and hitting the Diana is worth two. First up, Gustav from Madrid. Look at that sling. It's definitely the longest we've seen so far.
Representing Team GB, let's go.
Practice is over. From now on, every shot counts. Every hit of the board or strike of the Diana. And it's Chica's turn to make king and country proud. Stones may be new for him, but the same rules apply. Stay calm, remember the technique, and focus on the Diana. I don't even know where that went. But as stones are heavier, perhaps he needs to give it more power. He probably needs to release a bit earlier. Third try. Strike! 1 point for Team GB, and that's how it's done. Okay, stay calm, stay humble, stay focused. Ooh, too high again. This is not easy. Last try. And it's a miss. So that's 1 point out of five, but he still has a second round to go.
I got one. Thank you.
That was good.
Thank you.
That was good. Hit the target.
I got one.
First time in a competition, first time with rocks. That's impressive.
So far away.
Thank you.
Yeah, and 2 days ago as well. So
I didn't think I would get anywhere near it. So
that was good.
You even got past it at one.
I did.
I can't believe I hit the target. It's my first time ever with stones.
It's early days for this champion, and really this just isn't easy. It's hard to get the distance and height of the shot just right so it hits the target. But whereas some players like Chika are just about hitting the board and still making us very proud, others like Kavi from Mallorca are getting direct strikes to the Diana. And in between breaking Dianas, they're helping and giving advice to other slingers.
We arrived this morning.
Oh wow.
We didn't sleep at all, maybe 2 hours. And now we're here.
Straight into the competition. So I saw you broke the target.
I broke it. That only means a screw was not that good.
Okay.
Was broken.
But there must be a lot of power in that throw to damage it. So you're obviously very good.
Thank you very much.
So how long have you guys been slinging for?
Well, I start, I think, with at school with 12 years, about 26 years ago.
Wow.
I win on the Mallorcan competition, Balearic competition also, when I was a kid. And now we are here.
Wow.
It's the people, everybody's friendly, everybody wants to enjoy, everybody's...
Yeah, and that's what I've seen, everybody's encouraging each other, everyone's cheering when you hit the target.
If you see something, you're trying to help to each other, and that's the reason why.
Yeah.
Well, the game's heating up with everyone from Finland to Cuba taking their shots.
Yeah!
So after each game, the winners receive an award. Our friends Miriam and Mr. 2 million years of evolution are doing well. Competing in the championship is a great way to see the island as each round takes place in a different location. From the fields of San Jose in the day, we're moving to the town of Sant Carles by night.
So we've arrived at our final destination for the day. We're using tennis balls now, so the distance is a little bit shorter. It's 13 meters, and we have a bit of an audience, so better put on a good show. I guess I'm better at the stones. I was just a little bit to the left, a little bit to the right. It's a nice feeling when you connect and you hit the target. So a little bit disappointed, but it just goes to show that the people that are hitting the target consistently, like the level of skill that they have, you know? I mean, I was able to hit the target like twice today. You know, there's lots of guys that are just consistently hitting the target, and that's, you know, respect, because that's a lot of practice, a lot of skill. So yeah, this is definitely a game that requires skill and practice. So maybe this time next year I'll be as good as this guy here.
With the second game ending, more awards are handed out by Juan Carlos, the mayor of Sant Carles. For day two of the games, the gang returned to Sant Jose, the last opportunity to raise their scorecard. It came down to the final few battling for the title.
Yeah!
So the scores from all games across day one and day two have been counted and verified. And we can reveal the leaderboard for this year's championship. For women, in third place is Catherine with 22 points. In second place, Miriam with 23 points. And in first place, Maria with 23 points and 5 Dianas. For men, in third place is Modesto with 32 points. In second place is Channing, also with 32 points but 9 Dianas. And in first place with 41 points and 10 Dianas is Uwe, or Mr. 2 Million Years of Evolution. From holding a sling for the first time to training and representing Team GB, we follow Chika as he's discovered this riding sport inspired by local heritage. He may not have made the top three this time, but he'll return alongside even more slingers in what will be the biggest slinging championship yet. With associations and slinging groups rising in all corners of the world, it's only a matter of time before we all recognize slinging as an international sport. But until then, we can all follow in the bare footsteps of Uwe. He'll be back to defend his title, but the next champion could be you. So for more info about the next competition, all our travel series and our group holidays, visit Travvu.com. Hasta luego from the island that has it all, the island of Ibiza.
Club piano sounds better. Not vegetable. Vegetable piano sounds a bit weird.
Or the typical dance here, okay, with the clothes.
Yeah, we saw that clothes. Yesterday where the women like go like.
Yeah.
And the guys like.
Okay. It's
easy to say. Did you get it? You didn't get it. No. Yeah. Just say it again.
Dani! Chokagi, 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 chokagi.